back to the Peter Feely Experience number 7. I'm Peter Feely.
I'm Craig Smith.
And for the eagle-eyed people out there, we're in a new location.
Absolutely. We're in our home in Derbyshire near Ashbourne. Ashbourne is a beautiful place. If you've never been here, it's for a lot of tourists come here. But we've been looking to move here, and that's where we are at the moment, on the sofa.
So, it's been quite a few months since we did our last one, so it's just the turn of a new decade, 2020. Mm-hmm. So we thought we'd better get back on it and put a show out to you.
I think it was the summer since the last time we did one, episode 6, so we're getting our skates on and we're bringing you some new information.
And talking of the summer, we did our last perfume garden event in the summer.
It was a big event. We had moved it, didn't we, originally from its original place to the Blessington Carriage. Any of the people who went there know what a success it was, but it was an incredible, incredible success, I believe, and what happened. And we went for a few things. What did we do?
Well, with regarding clothes, we had a dear friend who was at the event, Andrew Bennett. He brought along quite a lot of his collection, so I did a Q&A with him. That was really interesting.
That was interesting, yeah.
Then we had Melanie Milkshake.
Ah, yeah. Melanie did a kind of a meditation, a very strange meditation. There were some videos of it somewhere online, so maybe you should go and find out on there and just type in Melanie Milkshake. Maybe she's on YouTube.
Yes, it was a kind of nice way to put an ending on that.
It was the last one, wasn't
yeah,
it?
Yeah, that was the last one, so it was kind of a nice way to say goodbye to all the people that have been to these Perfume Garden events during its time.
How many years has it been going, Pete?
About 5 or 6, so not that long really, but...
No. It just reached the end of that stage, but we're moving on to other bigger and better things, which we'll talk about later.
Yeah.
Okay. So, what's new, Pete? What are we going to be happening in 2020?
All right, there's a few things to mention on this show. I thought we'd start with the film.
Wow. Yes. So what's the name of the film?
Well, the film's called Golden Threads, A Tailor-Made Revolution. And how it come apart was about 18 months ago, I was contacted by a guy in America called Brian Kaufman. And basically, he was in the process of making a film stroke documentary on Jimi Hendrix.
Right, yeah, wow.
But it was kind of more to revolve around the clothing side of things, so he'd heard about me, so he emailed me and was just basically asking me a few questions about where certain garments might have come from, you know, and I did my best to help him with, you know, his questions. So I heard nothing more about it, and about 6 months ago, I got a email from Brian again, basically saying that the Jimi Hendrix estate basically put the kibosh on his idea of
the film. Oh no! So what did he do next?
Well, he'd already accumulated quite a lot of footage interviewing relevant people, so he thought instead of doing a film on Jimi Hendrix, he'd do a film on the clothing itself.
Yeah, the clothing scene and everything that goes with it.
So basically he asked, would I be interested in being involved? So I linked up, because he'd been over to the UK and initially did some interviews. So basically through the years of me doing my own research, you know, I've kind of got to know a few people that are still around, who are still with us.
Still with us, of course.
So I kind of set up some interviews for when Brian was coming over for 2 weeks. And also, Brian ordered a lot of stuff that was going to be left at my house, like a green screen, revolving pedestal thing where you could put the clothing on and it would revolve around.
Ah, here you went through a few dummies at that point, but you managed to find the right one. Yeah, he had a bit of difficulty, I remember that.
That in itself could take up a whole show, just trying to find...
Oh, you don't want to hear about that, no.
So basically, I set up some interesting interviews, which I'll talk about more in the future. And Brian came over to our house in Derby and did a interview with me, did some filming of the clothes. So Brian now has got all the information he needs.
Everything he needs.
All the filming he needs to you know, he's in the long process now of putting it all together.
When's it due out, this film? Do you know?
Well, at the moment, there's not an actual fixed date on when it'll come out, but hopefully there should be some semblance of a trailer put together very soon. And as soon as that is put, you know, put up, I'll on off next
Watch
show.
Watch space.
I'll put that.
Yeah, yeah, absolutely. That'll be on, hopefully, episode 8.
But hopefully, like, with regarding the film, I'm really excited because he's interviewed some really, really crucial people.
Name a few names, Pete.
Well, you've got Jared Mankiewicz, you've got Nigel Weymouth.
Oh, Nigel, of course.
John Pierce, Lloyd Johnson, Robert Orbach.
Wow, big names, very big names.
There's some interesting American people as well.
Now that's the part I've always been interested in as well. I mean, we don't hear too much about the American side of the clothing scene, so, well, I haven't anyway, so I'd be very interested to hear about that as well.
Where
do the birds get their clothes from, for example?
Exactly. Mm. Well, that's the whole field of the clothing that, you know, I'm pretty... I need enlightenment.
It'll be an education for everyone.
that's in the process of being made now. So,
fantastic.
Yes, an exciting thing to be happening in the future.
What next coming up this year, Pete?
Well, there's a couple of exhibitions to talk about.
Mm-hmm.
There's a couple of well-known people within the field of clothing from the past.
Right.
Mark and Cleo Butterfield.
Mm-hmm.
They're curating an exhibition in London this July at the Fashion and Textile Museum, and it's going to be titled "The Beautiful People," and basically it's around mainly the fashion boutiques of King's Road, male and female. So you've got Bazaar, you've got Quorum, you've got Granny Takes a Trip, Hung on You.
All the big names.
All the big names, but it isn't specifically King's Road, that, you know, there's Apple Boutique and many, many others.
Mm-hmm.
And I think it's from 66 to 76. So, you know, there was a lot of groundbreaking and innovations within the fields of fashion.
Wow. And who do you expect to be turning up? I mean, there's an opening night.
Before all that, I was contacted by Mark, and because he knew I was a collector, so he asked, would I like to loan some of my clothing, which I obviously obliged. So for the last few months, we've been in communication, just kind of planning what clothing I'm going to lend to the exhibition.
And what clothing have you chosen? I know there's an Elton John jacket, isn't
there? Yeah. Well, that's one of me. That's one of my newish acquisitions, which, you know, we can talk more about in other shows. But the actual clothing that I'm loaning, there's about 15 odd pieces, which at the moment I'm not really privy to talk more about.
Oh, I see.
At the moment, they're trying to get it's been officially announced, but I think they're trying to get some kind of brochure together.
Well,
you know, like with kind of some of the photos of some of the clothing.
I think it's going to be very special.
But it is going to be a very mouth-watering exhibition for the lovers and the discerning of the fashion of the 60s and early 70s.
And what are the dates so far? Do you have a date?
Yeah, it opens, I believe, July the 3rd. Till mid-October, so it's 3 months.
Yeah. Well, everyone book some time off and get down to London.
Yeah, you can actually book now.
Mm-hmm.
So
what's the web address? Do you know the website address?
We'll pop the web address on this, so, you know, from that then people can have a better look, and if they want to book tickets.
Mm-hmm.
So
get down there.
So also with regarding this event, I'm hopefully going to be sorting out some Q&As with some relevant people as well, and maybe doing some kind of talk myself, but this is all still in the planning stage, so so as you're saying, watch this space.
Absolutely, there's not much time to sort it out, but absolutely,
yeah. Great.
And that's all, folks. What else is happening, Pete?
Well, early last year, I put a proposal in to put on my an exhibition in my own city of Derby. There's a few nice museums that I thought might be appropriate. So basically I contacted Derby Museums and they were taking in proposals for exhibitions for 2022. So I put my proposal in and I got some interesting feedback from my initial proposal. And then I was interviewed and I found out a few months ago that I was successful, so...
Yeah, I couldn't believe it was fantastic. Well, I could believe it because you've got some great clothes, but, you know.
So the four of us are all involved in now, which is going to be my own exhibition of clothing from the mid to late 60s, and it's going to be titled Peter Feely, The Peacock Revolution. So we're all, like myself, Craig, Kath and Susie, who are behind the camera.
Yeah, behind the scenes.
we're all going to be involved in planning and getting this this whole exhibition together. Obviously, my side is the clothing, but Craig...
Yeah, there's a lot to organise, isn't there?
You're going to be...
Yeah, I'll be hopefully doing all the visuals and the graphics and just general art direction to make sure that it looks absolutely spot on and of the period, including the colour of the walls. You know, we're going to be painting, we're going to be decorating the museum, and it's going to look fabulous, I believe.
Well, we had a, just before Christmas, we had a meeting mm-hmm. with two representatives from Derby Museums, just to basically, Craig had a lot of questions he wanted to ask to basically find out how far we could go with it.
And it turns out we can go fairly quite far, really. I think
far out, man.
I think the good thing to do would be to see what they're doing in London and seeing what we can sort of ideas we can take from that. And we're on more of a restricted budget now, restricted budget. I mean, you know, to what they're doing in London, but there may be some good ideas we can take and to see what they're up to. And but we've got some great ideas of our own.
And you know, sometimes when you have got a restricted budget, you know, it makes you more creative in what you can produce anyway.
Yeah, absolutely.
So that's a really exciting one. That's it sounds like it's a long way off, 2022, but that's to start at the beginning of 2022, and it goes on for a whole year. So really speaking, we've only got a year to get everything in plan.
Absolutely. Let's get working on it, Peter.
Yeah, so that's going to be a pretty special thing for the four of us to be involved in.
That really is the next big perfume garden event, isn't it?
Yeah.
Because I believe there'll be an opening night and people will be able to come, and I think we'll hopefully try and get some celebrities as well, maybe.
I can't
guarantee anything at this stage, kids, but you know.
I took Kath and Craig to the actual the museum. It's actually called Pickford House. It's within the city centre of Derby.
Mm. Lovely building, old building.
And it's very conducive for, they put on fashion exhibitions, like next year's one is Florence Nightingale. 2019 was a famous lady from the 1920s called Lady Curzon, a fashionista, and it was a lot of her clothes from the 20s and 30s.
I think people who watch this show may be interested in that actually anyway, because there's a lot of influence on the 60s. So maybe you should get yourself down to the New York Museum in Derby.
Yeah.
So maybe you should get yourself down to Pickford House, Derby City Centre.
Yeah, definitely. Yeah, I think you'd, there's a lot that goes on within that museum, not just clothing. It's a Jacobean house, and it's pretty much been kept in the same setting as what it would have been back in those times.
Very beautiful. Get down there, kids. Right, Pete, what's up next? We've got some...
Well, you know, it wouldn't be a Peter Feely experience without any clothes.
Ties.
Okay, yeah, ties again.
What do we have here?
It seems to be a regular thread now within the shows. I promise there are lots and lots of clothes, but with us having to come to Ashbourne today, I thought it'd be easier just to bring some ties. And I have had some new ones since our last show. So the one you've got in your hand...
Yes.
..is a lovely kind of... It's like a castle silhouette in black, white and red, and it's silk, and that's from John Stevens.
Right, okay.
Of London.
It's immaculate condition.
Yeah.
No red, white stains on it or anything, I don't think.
No stains on that one.
No.
Like, can be classed as a kipper. I think at the widest base it's about 5 inches. So so that's
beautiful, absolutely.
So I picked that one up around the summer.
Great. What else do we have?
Well, I was lucky as well. I picked up some Mr. Fish ties. So
can you show that to the camera?
Yeah. So we've got one.
This
there.
Is a Mr. Fish.
Yeah, and we'll put more close-ups of the actual tie itself. Not as wide as the John Stephen, but obviously still a classic Mr. Fish kipper tie. Mm-hmm. You've got the label, the peculiar to Mr. Fish, and one of the giveaway idiosyncrasies for Mr. Fish ties in the lining. You always get the fish the.
I wonder if the camera could pick that up actually, see what you can do. Can you see the lining in there? Little bits of little fishes. Nice signature detail,
yeah,
isn't it?
It's a nice, it's a nice little extra detail, put into the Mr. Fish ties.
Okay.
So this is another Mr. Fish Paisley one. Same kind of width as the one we've just shown. And the actual label's located in a different area on this one. And yet again, you've got your
same signature on these.
You've got the line in a different colour this way, this time.
Good.
And last but not least, guess what? Another Mr. Fish.
No.
But this one, I've had this one many years.
Yes, beautiful.
But this one, unfortunately, hasn't got a label. But it's a lovely. It's as wide as the John Stevens one, about 5 inches at the bottom.
Inches.
Beautiful paisley pattern. And the way you can prove it is, it's still got its Mr. Fish lining.
Mm-hmm. Of course,
in
beautiful.
Gold.
Very nice gold ochre kind of colour, and paisley.
Yeah, beautiful.
Very original.
So it carries on my quite big tie collection.
This would go nice on maybe a black shirt.
Yeah.
Maybe against a black shirt, or maybe a colourful jacket.
Definitely. I always think when you've got quite a garish tie, a plain shirt, whether it's cotton or satin.
And what about the jacket? What would you use? Would you maybe pick out the green in the jacket, maybe?
Maybe, there's
malt. I mean, who knows? I mean, go as colourful as you like.
To me, that'd go nice with one of my Regency coats.
Maybe,
a nice black one or
maybe
green
you'll see.
One.
Maybe you'll wear it to one of your exhibitions, eh?
Maybe, yeah. And obviously, these would be nice props.
Yes.
That I'll include when I have my exhibition.
Of many props, I believe that we're going to have. Yes.
And over the talking of clothes, we want to try and make these shows more regular now. So, in future shows, I'll be featuring a lot more of my collections through the years. Mm-hmm. And I'm hoping to, at some point in the year, do a special on a guy called Timothy Allen.
Right.
Timothy basically he worked at Hung On You when it moved to the King's Road location, and he was also part of the English Boy Model Agency, which I'll talk more about as well for those people that might not know. I got in contact with Timothy last year through a Facebook page, and it ended up that he still had quite a few Hung On You garments, which I've managed to purchase from Timothy. So at some point in the year, I'd like to do a special on Timothy and the Hung On You garments
that'd
that
be fab.
I've managed to acquire.
Fantastic.
So I think that about ties it up.
I think
ties it up.
Ties
pardon,
it up. Yeah.
Pardon the pun.
I was going to say wraps it up, but absolutely ties it up, yeah.
For once, I've beaten you to a point. So.
Brilliant. Great, guys. Thanks for tuning in, and stay tuned for the next episode coming up hopefully very soon.
And like I said, as the shows go on, when I've got more information on the film, the London exhibition, and my exhibition, as the shows progress, I'll pass on more information as I know it.
Yeah.
So thanks for watching, and welcome into 2020.
Welcome. Are we going?
You might find something that you want to put in.
She's a dedicated follower of fashion. Oh, yes, he is.